The ACCC has received a number of extremely concerning reports about very high pricing for rapid antigen tests. Many of the reports are between $20 and $30, which is concerning. And then we've had reports, a number of reports, well above $30, which of course is just beyond outrageous. The wholesale prices we're hearing about are anywhere between $3.95 and say $7 to $8. Sometimes those prices go up to $11.45, but you can see when the bulk of the wholesale pricing is between say $4 and $8 that the pricing between $20 and $30 is extremely concerning, and as I say, above $30, just beyond outrageous. We are writing out to, or we have already written out to, a range of chains to get them to explain their pricing. And we're also writing out to individual stores to get them to explain their pricing. Some individual stores within chains are pricing at very high levels, and we have a large number of reports of them doing so. And so we're very much looking forward to what their explanations are for those, for the very high pricing that has been reported that they are selling their goods at. Often, some of these high prices are from stores you wouldn't expect, petrol retailers, tobacconists, some convenience stores. So we're very much looking at those as well as pharmacies. We've had reports of some outlets not issuing receipts or demanding that payment be made in cash. There's only one reason why I would think outlets are doing that, and we need to remind people that it's actually illegal not to provide a receipt if asked for purchases of $75 and above. So we're looking very closely at that also. We've also had reports of companies or outlets selling packs designed for wholesale at a retail level. Now, some packs are designed, for example, to be only used at medical facilities with trained operators, but they are being broken down and sold at retail. Not only are we looking at that, but we're sending those complaints off to the Therapeutic Goods Association Administration. We've also had reports that look as if people have bought the goods at retail and then unsold them at more than a 20% markup, and that is illegal under the government's recent announcement, and we're referring anything that looks of that nature to the Australian Federal Police. We're also looking at specific instances of misleading conduct. I had a letter over the weekend from Minister Hunt pointing out that he's aware of some outlets saying that where supplies being paid for, the supplier's saying, no, we can't provide it to you because the government's requisitioned it or diverted it. I'm assured by Minister Hunt that that's not true, and therefore statements like that would amount to misleading conduct. So a range of very concerning pricing. We're looking at the reasons why outlets are doing that. We have an eye to naming and shaming, but we're also looking at whether the conduct could amount to unconscionable conduct, and we're also looking at what's being said to see whether consumers are being misled, as well as, I say, as referring matters to the Therapeutic Goods Administration and the Federal Police in appropriate circumstances. So a lot going on. I'm really hoping that companies hear this message and adjust their behaviour very quickly so that we get sensible pricing for all Australians as fast as possible.